So, everyone, Wanderbot here, and welcome back to Cavern Kings. Anyway, we're going to be trying something kind of hard. I don't know who I want to play. Yeah, I might come back to Hand of Fate tonight, but honestly, let's be totally honest here. It's hard. Hand of Fate is hard. I want to play something a little bit more friendly. Now, we've got actually probably one of the better combos for doing the arena. The drill cannon is a little bit on the weak side, but at the same time, we got the shovel, which is pretty solid as far as... the drill cannon is incredibly solid later game once you have some basic buffs, and it's also long range, which is exactly what you need on a run. The only thing that would maybe be better than this could possibly be Yoji with... Yoji with a saw blade cannon, because the thing is, the saw blade cannon... Oh, shit, I need that. I need that really freaking badly. Okay. So the reason why Yoji is, of course, purely because he's got such high melee DPS comparatively. And the saw blade cannon... Oh god, that's worthless for me right now. I really want to succeed at this on the first try, but I doubt it. Yoji's sword skills are amazing. The only reason why I pick Alium here is just so we have some maneuverability. Thorax might actually be pretty solid, but god damn, this thing hands out health like... Alright, let's try Thorax next. This game does not hand out health at all. It's weird. Alright, this isn't gonna work. There's no way I'm going to be able to take out... Oh, wait, we don't want standard. There's no way I'm going to be able to take out anything at a range. With a TNT. Like, this is a very specific challenge. And, man, they can't come sooner with the weapon select. Wow, that is, like, the shittiest combo. This is why we're picking Thorax, so we can just keep re-picking. Because... This will probably work. Hey, Wombat, how's it going? And Wombat-related friendlies. Alright, so, Harpoon Gun, a little bit on the slow side. But if I can get some buffs for it, it's not so bad. So it does, like, all sorts of damage. And we actually... Oh, man. If I could get the Drill Cannon along with the Harpoon Launcher, we'd be really underpowered from the beginning. But... Boy, would we be able to, like, get pretty far towards the end. Unfortunately, this game also hands out, you know, healing items. Like, completely, I don't know, just hands out healing items, like, as if they were gold bricks to homeless people. I don't even know. I have, like, no good analogy to use here. Oh, at least we get the one item that we, like, kind of can make up for our shortcomings as far as Thorax goes. Only it actually made a difference here. Well, it does. It's just not as much as I'd like. But the nice thing is I can pretty much clear the floor every time. I'm just worried about the eyeballs. More than anything else. Oh, man, that was a healing item. I wanted it so bad. Oh, speaking of. Oh, right. I don't have any vortex boxes, so it means nothing. Well, at least we get damage here. And lots of it, actually. Come on, we got this. Just gotta keep wrecking business. Unfortunately, there are a lot of, like, really redundant items that drop. This arena mode does not have an adjusted item table at all. It's just like, alright, same item table, you just get things sooner. Because there are no chests in this game. Actually, I kind of wish enemies would just routinely drop chests. That would actually save on a lot of trouble. Oh, hello. Don't want to get hit by, like, any of that business. We might actually make this as Thorax, which is hilarious, because I don't think I ever even considered him when I was originally trying to farm, what was it, the shark up? Yeah, it was the shark. Because, like, the thing is, I'm poo-pooing. Oh. I don't think I'm going to be able to get that. Yeah, no, I do not have enough upward trust to get that. But yeah, Thorax just natural defenses is enough to make him the most viable. Comparatively, I'm just very worried about the giant worms and the freaking you and the everything else. Oh boy, this is a mess. Because yeah, we don't have any healing items. We're completely dependent on... We're completely dependent on drops. Speaking of, great timing, horrible placement. Great, horrible timing, really. Because unfortunately, we're getting the big stone guys, and I have jack shit for items. Like, I have a stone clump. Ah, this is brutal. Whew. Oh, let's see. Let's keep going. I'm gonna keep going with Thorax. He really does need possibly shovel drill cannon. Shovel drill cannon or no. No. We're not gonna be able to hit anything at a distance. And if we can't take out the eyeballs, we're sunk. Hello, let's try this. Because we're slow as shit, but the shovel is actually going to be very good for taking out enemies near us. I just really hope the drop rates are better than this. I feel like I should go play Risk of Rain. I did want to do a little bit more on the... Nah. Alright. The nice thing is the eyeballs pretty much die, but like, Mole's Orchid is the most useless piece of crap that you can ask for. On the arena, because it's like, alright, the thing that heals you for digging. Oh, wait. Good luck digging. Like, I don't know. I guess, apart from taking it out, really they just need to give you, like, more healing items or a Heart of Belial earlier. Otherwise, you're just sunk. I think I've won this with Yoji. Yeah, I absolutely did. Now, usually I like the Toxic Vial or Toxic Flask. There we go. But, yeah. And you guys are a concern to me because I can't kill you easily and I can't aim because I also have to focus on like all of these guys all over the place. Okay, well, we were full health for a bit and should be fine. Fortunately, I'm going to be very focused on what I'm doing here, so chat's gonna have to be a little bit neglected. Oh, there we go. Oh, missiles. Please... if I can get, like, three missiles, we've got it made. Unfortunately, there's just, like, a unending stream of just eyeballs from up above. Okay. I think we're okay. Whew. We're not... Yeah. Wow, the shovel is not enough. No! Fuck. Damn it! It is a quiet night at this point. That's okay. It's also, what, Monday night? Go figure, people are tired. Nope. I'm a little bit disappointed with the arena that they even have the holes in the ground. I know why they exist, but, like, when you're Thorax, there ain't much you can do about it. Don't want the Power Fist. Alright, let's try this. This might be a bit of a pain in the butt. But it might also work, because the saw blades just pass straight through people. They don't do that much damage in the beginning, but once you get, like, they scale the best with the clusters of iron. Get a couple of those? Actually, they do a fair amount of damage. But get a couple of clusters of iron, you're all good. Unfortunately, I don't exactly know how well we're going to do here. But, like, I would rather have the jackhammer, despite the fact that it's kind of less useful with damage, just because it does scale fairly well with items, specifically the Hero of Time sword or whatever it's called. But mainly, it means I can get up, which is something I don't generally have the ability to do. But it means I can also float above enemies. Whereas the shovel, until you have like enough attack speed, that is just not doable. Come on. Weirdly enough, the eyeballs seem to die on their own, which I'm kind of appreciative of. It makes my life a lot easier. I just wish there was a way that I could just float permanently. Now, in some baseline level, it could be possible to do this with Entite, but I don't think that would work particularly well. Oh, good. We got a boxing glove. And we got a Hero of Time sword, which is going to do us almost nothing. Yeah, unfortunately, there's also no iframes when you take damage. You just keep taking damage. So I can just get hammered by, like, infinite enemies for quite a while, and it's not going to mean anything. Oh, please, knives. Actually, save me here. More boxing gloves. Tempting. If only I could deal with it. Unfortunately, those eyeballs also explode for inadequately explained reasons. Oh, we've got some good items already. But it's probably going to mean nothing here. Come on. One of you guys give me a healing item. I might be able to pull this off, assuming if I get one. That's not a healing item, but it's very necessary. Where's all this shit coming from? Oh! Oh god. Oh, so very close to death. Yeah, that is brutal. Like, those clusters of iron are absolutely necessary. At least we didn't start off with a Mole's Orchid. Almost. This is the other reason why I'm picking Thorax. Thorax, you can quickly cycle in and out. You can also crash the game. So, no. I don't like the fact that there's actually a quit to desktop button right next to exit to menu. Like, I'm being very careful here not to touch it, but it's just, it is so easy to do. And man, it is just not giving me the good items I want. Like, it's giving to them to me piecemeal, so, yeah, I can probably, well, this is what I had last time, which actually got me the farthest. And I know I could probably do this with Yoji, because he's the best of both worlds between the jackhammer and the shovel, but better at both. But I would like to actually be unique here. And, you know, make it on my own. Unfortunately, since we can't dig, and this game is all of the healing related items in this. Oh, hello. You might actually make my life a lot easier. Since it's so sparing with all of the healing items here, it's just like, alright, well, good luck making it particularly far. So someday I would like to get, like, I think it's 30 minutes into the arena or an hour into the arena, both of which are pretty ridiculous, mind you. Getting to those actually gets you, like, something else. Maybe a golden gun? I don't know, that'd be kind of cool. Unfortunately, seems largely unattainable for the time being, but we've got a black hole box right off the bat. Like, maybe if you could pick 5 items to bring into the arena with you once you've unlocked the shark, that'd actually be really cool, actually. If you could do that, where it's like, alright, you know, here's your starting equipment, so you actually have a chance at this. Speaking of chance at this, unfortunately that does not give us as much of a boost as I want. But it does help a lot. Because yeah, what do we need at this point? More of those would be nice. Dracul Blood, missiles, especially because this weapon fires pretty quickly. Missiles would be great. Knives are good. Homesick shards are kind of nice for keeping enemies off of me. A shield would be amazing. But I think Dracul Blood and Heart of Belial. Both of those would be super solid. Actually, holy crap. Right off the bat, 3. I don't even know how many items I have. Not many. And 3 of them are clusters of iron. Of course, it immediately starts scaling that difficulty up. That difficulty. Fuck. This is bad. At least, it seems like some of the eyeballs have killed themselves already. And I'm not getting a whole lot of healing here either. Getting something. Oh, shit. Alright. That hurt a little. But at the same time, we've got double jackhammer. We've got multiple clusters of iron. We've got knives. We've got all sorts of stuff. Good. The problem is the saw blades are awful at taking out worms, because it usually just takes out one of the later parts and nothing else. Wow, did I missed with every single one of the. Oh, ho! Nice thing is we got triple jump now. Okay, we might. actually do some... We might do somewhat well here. Come on. Here's to hope. Here's to... butt kicking. Goodness. Come on. Alright. So there's a Heart of Belial. There's our poison. Okay, we might make it on this one. We might make it on this one. Okay. This episode of, oh man, this episode of Cavern Kings will not be particularly rant-worthy, specifically because I'm trying my hardest to live. Okay. And I'm doing a fairly good job of it, comparatively. Yeah, the drop, RNGesus is really, really working with me here. Other things that would help a lot, more jumps. Getting a bunch of jumps, a couple of wind leaves would be maybe nice, but I think the jumps would be better. Multiple drills, the Zephyr's Horn or whatever it's called, for melee attack speed, just so I have like complete permanence in the air. But that said, you need to do a lot of jumping anyway. Oh, another Heart of Belial. Thank you so much. And pretty soon we will be able to get up onto those upper tiers if I need to, considering those are actually fairly safe. Though they tend to be rife with surprises, but we've got, what, several Hearts of Belial now? God, we're just getting hammered with worms, though. Which is not welcome. Oh, well. More black hole boxes we got going for us. Yeah, there's all sorts of eyeballs going on. I need more missiles, actually. Getting a bunch of missiles would save this run. A lot of grief, just because. Ooh, Draco Blood. Yes. Alright, so that gives me some active healing, sort of. To anything close to me, which is, a little bit harder, but at the same time, it means I can just kind of power through a lot of basic types of enemy. With the Draco Blood, we've got, wasn't even paying attention, but I knew something in there was good. Okay, all the health pickups. Yeah, we got this! Of course, now my nose starts itching like crazy. That's okay, we were at a bit of a slow point anyway. Okay! Oh, that blue-faced enemy is kind of rough. Now what do we need? Scattershot. Ooh, those swords are going to be helpful. Scattershot would be beautiful. We do a fair amount of damage here, but it's in very localized places, and if I can spread them all over. Speaking of, more black hole boxes, more wind leaves. I'm just tanking it now because this character is very tough. And we do, like I said, we do have active healing, so assuming I can just kind of power through. Unfortunately, we lose health. We lose the ability to use our kind of mid-range attack. The Hero Time Sword, or whatever it's called, the Hero Sword, is really ridiculous. Especially when you have, like, a lot of attack speed and multiple weapons, because it scales both. Very nicely, too. But I'm feeling pretty good about this. We're getting all sorts of loot here. We're 6 minutes in. So we're definitely unlocking the shark, if we, you know, needed to unlock the shark here. Oh, shit! Didn't realize there was a bot. Oh, God, he did not survive. I guess he just passed straight through all of my saw blades, which did not agree with him. Alright, so I'm getting hammered here. But at the same time, most enemies seem to be dying faster than they seem to be killing me, and I seem to be healing fairly effectively here. Also, the more black hole boxes I get, the less I have to travel for loot, which is welcome. Yeah, no, that is going to be super, super helpful. Alright, so I think this is going to be the only run of the arena we do, just because I don't think I'm going to be able to top this. Now, that said, I do kind of wish I had the drill cannon here, but I don't think we'd be doing particularly well with it. Like, I don't think we would have actually aced this run. We're already on the Titan Bloodworms. That is concerning. They are going to kill us. Wow, we're already at 310 health, though. That is good. Not a whole lot of defensive items, and I really need Scattershot. Give me some Scattershot here, and we're just going to ruin everything. Speaking of, holy shit, that's a lot of eyeballs. I need more jumps. Come on, hand me some more jumps here. I am deserving. Oh, well, at least we got homesick shards up the wazoo now. All right. Those eyeballs do not want me to win this run. Not like you can really win the arena. God, I can't wait until I can do the arena with, like, friends for multiplayer. Because I think it would be brilliant. Just gotta chunk our way through. This is... Yeah, this is going very well. Technically, we've done better once. But at the same time, that was, like, super desperate. And this, while it's a pain in the ass, it seems largely achievable comparatively. I'm just getting pummeled here, though. That was a lot of eyeballs that spawned at the same moment. This is unfortunately... Holy crap. Oh, there's a boxing glove. Oh, I can get it anyway. Unfortunately, I haven't gotten a whole lot of missiles here. Yeah, only two. I need a bunch of those, because... eventually, missiles and boxing gloves are going to be our primary way of clearing out enemies at a range, because the saw blades, a little bit less so. Hey, missile. I was just talking about needing you. And we're already at level 24. Holy crap. Oh, hey. The blazing trail is actually going to be really helpful. You know, in terms of leveling scale, we're pretty much at the cusp of cycling here. Yep, thought so. I unlocked the vacuum stone. Never done that before. Alright. Wonder why I get that. Alright. I ain't complaining. Interesting question what it does. Reduces the cost of chests. Yes, of all of the most useful things. Oh well. I really hope we can get some scattershot here. Because we get scattershot, we're just going to wreck face on everything. I mean, currently we wreck pretty hard as it is, but this is good. Yeah, I have no idea what the vacuum stone is. I've never even heard of it. I'd swear I've looked at every... Oh, sweet. Wow, we're just rolling in it now. It's just handing us pickups left and right. Hey, we finally got the Tesla coil. All right, suck it, Android. I have now stolen your powers. Wow, this is getting fun. I think we're going to make it at least to the 10-minute mark, unless something comes and murders me in the next 20 seconds. But yeah, not a whit. Well, they're going to try. Oh, crap. I did not want to pick that up. That said, I'll be okay. Probably. Because let me guess. Am I? Oh, I'm still shooting. Like, the bug with scattershot is very confusing. It's very irregular. If that makes sense. Because, like, here I feel like I'm still shooting. I have no idea if I'm still shooting or not. Maybe they're still going. So, maybe it's based on, like, where you go, what you do? I have no idea. Oh, well, yeah, we've made it past the 10-minute mark, but, God, everything is exploding pretty hard now. Our frame rate is going way off the charts. This is something special. At least we've got a lot of healing and a lot of... magnetism. Our vac, I don't know, black hole-ishness? Shit, this is insane. Alright, we've almost cleared them out. Whew. Okay, what do we get for that? Nothing useful. Yeah, what I want now that I got burst fire is I want more burst fire. Once you got one, you need more. Oh, shit. Jumps. Didn't even realize it there. Wow, we were just rolling in pickups. Like, wind leaves abound. Shit, it's just like an unending stream of junk. Some of it good, some of it bad. I don't even know. Alright, well, that's okay with me. Oh, there's a missile pickup in there. I don't think I got it. No, I didn't. There's another one over here, though. I think we got that one. Alright. So as long as we don't get touched by the... Wow, this is insane. It's not giving me... giving my inventory feed room to breathe. Oh. We've gotten everything. But we haven't gotten ourselves a scattershot yet, which is weird. Alright, well, it's not the end of the world either. Because we're at 12 minutes. We're just shy of, but... Oh, man. We've almost gotten to the point where the black hole boxes actually cover the entire screen. That is really good. Yeah, this is going to be one of the longer runs today. And I'm totally okay with that, because I've never gotten this far. In arena, and I'd like to see if I can make it to the half hour mark, if possible. Even if our frame rate is going to be the most variable I've seen in a very long time. Hopefully they optimize this game a little bit. I don't even know how many jumps I have. I wish there was like a little pip counter. It's like here's how many jumps you have left, because, well, I jump a lot. Yeah, at this point we're actually cleaning house as far as gems go, which is kind of nice. Unfortunately, I don't think I've gotten any of the golden bullet things yet. No, but I need to get those. Give me one of those. Suddenly our damage is going to go through the freaking roof. Oh, nope. There's an extra jump in there. Oh, well. There's also a bunch of Hearts of Belial in there. So, holy crap. What is all that stuff? Oh, Vigor Beetle. Me likey. Wow. This is fun. So the unfortunate part is, since we have Burst Shot, I really haven't gotten the chance to test this. Oh, there's a boss in there. Somewhere. When he decides to actually come and say hi, unless he already died. I have no idea. No, he's still hiding in there. Yeah, turns out Thorax is probably the best character in the game. Also kind of the shittiest if you've never unlocked anything. You gonna actually come down here and fight me, or are you just gonna hide up there? Alright. I guess he's just gonna hide up there. There we go. Took you long enough. What did I even get from that? Another Vigor Beetle. Well, that's probably gonna... Well, that's gonna help extend the run, just because... Well, the more health I have, the better. We're only at 13 minutes. Wow. This is gonna get nuts by the time we hit the 30-minute mark. I can guarantee that. How many missiles do I got? I got 9. Sweet. This is making life so much easier on me. But still, not a sign of a scattershot. Lots of clusters of iron. Like, we're firing off some pretty big saw blades, and that's not even scumming the battery for, like, crazy blasts. And like, we do have burst fire, which does help, because we're effectively firing two at a time. Now, here's the question. If I just sit here and click... Alright, so... I do have to keep clicking here. So if you can hear that, I apologize. I prefer to not just be able to hold stuff down, but to be able to fire my gun because of the weird burst fire bug, I gotta keep clicking forever. Oh, hey, finally a scattershot. All right, now we're going to be firing off 4 at a time, which is going to just totally wreck face. Of course, you know, not quite as effective since they arc and stuff, but it's going to keep the ground clear. This is going to get fun. I am just rolling in all of the items. We're pretty much getting to the point where we've got... What am I even listening to? I don't even know. We're getting to the point where we're almost to the point where we have more missiles than we've ever had before, which is great. We're level 30, which is actually really high level. I wonder... Yeah, you can go above level 30. Good to know. This is all sorts of nuts. And, yeah, suddenly, this just seems so much more achievable, because I barely even see my health drop anymore. Okay, oh boy, that is a lot of jackhammers. You know how I always talk about wanting to get the, like, ball of jackhammers to the point where it's, like, maxed out and stuff? I think this is going to be the run for that. Because, well, we've already got, like, maybe a third, maybe just shy of a third covered in it. This is Metal Gear Solid music, isn't it? I think it is. Hard to remember. How many Hearts of Belial do I have at this point? 13! Holy crap! I don't even know what my fast healing is, but it's gotta be insane. Oh. Do I have the music turned super loud so nobody can hear it? That's a shame. I can turn it up if nobody can hear it. I didn't even realize nobody can hear my music. But then again, people are probably not here for the music, so there's also that. But yeah, I want to be the ball of jackhammers, just because it's like, all right, nothing can penetrate me. I think that's the first flashbang grenade we got. Nope, apparently I have 2. All right, yeah, this is Metal Gear Solid music. Okay, oh yeah, I don't know. I get weirdly self-conscious about clicking noises with anything. Actually, I get weirdly self-conscious about noises at all, because. Like, when I was first doing YouTube, I guess I can start rant botting just because we've gotten to the point where we're just, or story bot, I don't even know. But we've gotten to the point where I, like, largely don't have to worry about anything. Our frame rate, though, boy. This is something special. It's like, it goes into stop motion every once in a while. Jeez. You know what? Can I go into the options? Screen shake. Off. Zoom. Well, it still goes a little bit posy, but it's not so bad. Yeah, it is Snake Eater. Thought so. But so when I was first starting YouTube, and probably none of you watching this were around then, obviously, because I was just starting. 0 subscribers at that point. But so for the first, like, month or so, I didn't... not even a month. I think I actually bought a microphone fairly quickly in. But the first, like, maybe 5 episodes that I ever recorded was with my laptop mic. And it was just the most atrocious sounding thing you probably would expect from somebody. And honestly, like, I went back, actually. It was kind of interesting. I went back and listened to some of the bigger YouTubers at the time. I'm specifically thinking of, like, Vanoss, and actually mostly Vanoss, who's fairly popular, I believe. And dude had a worse microphone than I did. Like, sounded horrifying. And he had, like, 100,000 subscribers at the time, and it's just like, holy crap. You know, people have, like, zero standards, or, you know, I guess fans will be fans, regardless of what's going on. So we got some aces, we got all sorts of stuff. Oh, hey, a drill! Does nothing useful for us, but still. But, let's see. But so I sounded awful, and, like, I'm super glad that I finally got a microphone. But ever since, I've been, like, specifically very conscious about how much background audio I have. So, like, I specifically bought my computer parts with the intent of picking the quietest possible rig I could manage. And, like, it still makes noise. I can hear it if I really crank up my own audio. But at that point, like, I am deafening, so I don't really have to worry about that much. How many jumps do we have? Like 13-ish? Because you add the number of angel rings. All right, this run is not going to end anytime soon. Probably. Which means we're going to hit the 20-minute mark. Hopefully the 30-minute mark. But yeah, a lot of people were, like, more interested in the humor and whatnot than the quality of the sounds. But, like, for me, I want to have, like, the absolute maximum sound quality. So whenever I give, like, anybody advice on, like, how to start YouTubing, it is purely just get yourself a good microphone and then start. You're going to sound like crap because you don't know what you're doing, but once you have that good microphone, you're at least not going to sound... Well, okay, you're going to be crap, but at least you're not going to sound crap, if that makes sense. But so... Just audio quality for me is one of the most important things, which is weird because I'm not an audiophile. Like, I don't even have that great of headphones. I just got a pair of Heshes. But, like, I guess I just have an extremely picky bar of, like, anything. Oh, no. Fuck. That could have gone bad. Something must have blown up right next to me. Oh, yeah, one of the yellow enemies, or the orangish enemies, will just kind of, like, sit there and wail on you. That was very, very close. I really want to make it to this 30-minute mark. I guess at this point, the only thing that can probably kill me... is... Okay, no, two things can end this run. A, we get pushed into the spikes, which would be brutal and very frustrating. B, game could crash. Those are the two things that I can foresee killing me. How many wind leaves? I think I move faster than a regular character at this point. Thorax has overcome his baseline... crippling nature of the, or his crippling inability to move. Now, do I only have, oh, I do have scattershot, so I'm actually firing 6 rounds at a time. Go figure, we're slowing down. Like, the thing is, I am an audiophile, but I think it's only to a certain point. Like I said, like, I really like good sounding audio, but, I guess maybe for me being a true audiophile, I actually only like listening to music through one headphone, purely because I'm always in a situation where I want to hear what's going on. Either, you know, somebody else talking, myself speaking, because, like, I only have one headphone on right now. And if I could actually get a pair of, like, really good headphones for one ear and, like, screw the other ear, I'd actually be totally satisfied. Because, like, for me right now, if I was wearing both headphones on, I would actually be a good 3 to 5 decibels louder, if not more, purely because I would have no idea how loud I am. So this way, by having, you know, the headphones off, I can manage my sound. So I would love to be, like, a true audiophile with, like, super expensive headphones and stuff like that, but for the time being, I'm just sort of kind of like, sort of, kind of? But I guess it just translates to being more picky about, like, bad audio than picky about, like, true high-quality audio. I also never have enough hard drive space to, say, justify having FLAC. even though FLAC does sound better. Unless you have, like, really good headphones, it's not really super important on. Like, just for listening. Not to mention, I own almost no music whatsoever. All of the music I own is either free from, like, OC Remix and stuff, or from Humble Bundles. I, like, bands, like, big label bands, I don't have... Oh, is that my first money shot? No, we have two now. Oh, that explains why things are dying even faster. But I don't buy music. I think largely it's fairly overpriced in a lot of cases. Just kind of not worth it. Especially because it's like, alright, here's an album. I will be able to listen to this for like maybe a week or two before going insane and losing it, so I need to get more music. Alternatively, I can just listen to online radio forever and it's just like, alright, close enough. So for not having like a very high quality, you know, sound formats, I listen to the internet, which is even lower quality, technically. Though I think you can crank it up in certain cases, it's not worth it.